Yeah, so today we're gonna go and try to go into some basics, man. He get worse every time I see him, man. He used to have two legs. Now he missing one now. He was scoffing too, man. Oh, we lied, man.
All praises to Yahweh by Shem, Yahweh Shai, Wahava Kabadash, double honors to the apostles and the elders, and great millstone, the teachers of the word of truth, sincerity, and rule and wealth. Salutations to our fellow Aki brothers and four corners of the globe, preaching in the name of Yahweh by Shem, Yahweh Shai, man. All right, we out here another week, the Wadi Yahweh by Shem, Yahweh Shai, another live stream preaching. Got a couple things we're going to go into, you know, and wherever else the Spirit leads us off, we're going to go into some of the basics. Okay, today, all right, so the first thing we're going to get, we're going to talk about Jacob and Esau, man. And truth, we're going to go into who is Esau, what is the Edomite, what does the Edomite look like, going into Leviticus chapter 16. Okay, we're going to go into that, either 16 or 13. I got to look it up. But we'll start off with Genesis 25 and 19.
The book of Genesis, chapter 25, verse 19. And these are the generations of Isaac, Abraham's son. Abraham begat Isaac, and Isaac was 40 years old when he took Rebekah to wife.
All right, so what we're learning about is, we're learning about the forefathers of Jacob. His name was eventually changed to Israel.
The book of Genesis, chapter 25, verse 20. And Isaac was 40 years old when he took Rebekah to wife, the daughter of Bethuel, the Syrian of Padan Aram, the sister of Laban, the Syrian. And Isaac entreated the Most High for his wife because she was barren.
Right, so Isaac went to the Most High and prayed to Yahweh, why Yahweh Shai. You know, Isaac was asking Yahweh Shai. But when I say the Lord's name, you say it in the name of his son. Okay? But Isaac, he went to go pray for his wife because he was barren. He didn't have no children. He couldn't have any children. So he prayed for it, man. Go ahead.
And the Lord was entreated of him, and Rebekah, his wife, conceived.
Yep.
And the children struggled together within her. And she said, if it be so, why am I thus? And she went to inquire of the Most High.
Yeah, of the Lord, Yahweh. Of Yahweh. She went to inquire of Yahweh. All right, because she's like, look, man, I can pray for you to be able to have children. Now that I'm pregnant, why am I born to this? Because it was worse. It wasn't the common child rolling around in the stomach and, moving around. They were fighting. You know, it was a tumultuous battle. And this would be a sign, a symbol of what's to come in the future. Okay? And what would that be? There will always be common adversity. And the children of Esau, man. But the children of Jacob are the Israelites. The children of Esau are the Edomites, man. Okay?
And Yahweh said unto her, two nations are in thy womb.
So even though these dudes were twins, fraternal twins, okay, they weren't identical, they were fraternal. And it's going to go into that. Even though they were fraternal twins, read that again.
And Yahweh said unto her, two nations are in thy womb.
Yeah, two nations. So even though they were fraternal twins, they weren't going to be of the same nation. Even though they came out of Isaac, they were going to be the progenitor of two different nations, two distinct nations, okay?
Two manners of people shall be separated from thy bowels.
The two manners of people, meaning two different types of people, but will come from her bowels. You won't have a righteous, okay?
And the one people shall be stronger than the other people, and the elders shall serve the younger.
Yeah, the one people that shall be stronger than the other people, Israel, the Israelites, Jacob, his seed was going to be stronger than his brother's seed, which is the Edom, which is the seed of Esau, Edom.
And when her days to be delivered were fulfilled, behold, there were twins in her womb.
Fraternal twins, go ahead.
And the first came out red all over like a hairy garment.
So it was red all over like a hairy garment. And who looks like that when they're born? The Edomites, man. So-called white people, man. When you're born now, like a brother, we'll call you one from the UK, explain, okay, when children are born, we all have a red, stuck a red hue to us. Because we're coming out of our mother's womb, the sun hasn't hit it yet, okay? But we don't come out as red as Esau. Edom, when he comes out, he's red all over. His blood is like beet red, man, okay? And that's because due to a lack of pigmentation, man, a lack of melanin, all right? When you,
And they called his name Esau.
Esau, in the Hebrew, that word Esau is Aishashua. Wasted away, man, because everybody else of a brown hue, of melanin, dark skin, okay? When Esau was born, he was the first ever to be born looking like that. Now that goes back to Cain. When Cain was given the mark, the Most High struck him with leprosy, like he did Mary. And matter of fact, hold that, go to Numbers chapter 12. We're gonna go to Numbers chapter 12 real quick. Just to show you, give you an example of what that looks like, okay? Numbers chapter 12. Oh, yep, you can start at 1. 12 and 1.
This is the book of Numbers, chapter 12, verse 1. And Miriam and Aaron spake against Moses.
Aaron
spake against Moses because of the Ethiopian woman whom he had married, for he had married an Ethiopian woman.
Yeah, so they basically like, look, he's supposed to be the prophet of the Lord. He's supposed to be basically the Israelite of all of Israelites. And he's going to marry an Ethiopian woman. Why he didn't choose a woman from one of the tribes? You know, talking shit. You read it?
And they said, Hath Yahweh indeed spoken only by Moses? Have he not spoken also by us? And the Lord heard it.
Yeah, because it was both of them talking, but it was really Miriam that was talking the most shit. Okay? Talking about, you know, basically, he ain't just speaking to Moses. He's speaking to all of us, man. So why is he the one that the Lord is doing? And he's dealing with us, and on top of that, he married a Ethiopian, a Christian woman. You know what I'm saying?
Now the man Moses was very meek above all the men which were humble upon the face of the earth.
Very, very humble, man. Okay, go ahead.
And Yahweh spake suddenly unto Moses and unto Aaron and unto Miriam, come out ye three unto the tabernacle of the congregation. And they three came out. And Yahweh came down in the pillar of the cloud and stood in the door of the tabernacle and called Aaron and Miriam, and they both came forth. And he said, Hear now my words. If there be a prophet among you, I, the Most High Yahweh, will make myself known unto him in a vision.
That's right. So the Most High, He was like, basically like Miriam, Moses, Miriam, Aaron. Come here. He wasn't mad at Moses, man. He's defending his prophet, man. And the scripture says, touch not my anointed, neither be my prophet in your heart, man. Okay? Here it is. This is the Most High anointed Moses, okay? And Aaron and his sister, mainly his sister, that black, she was being a demon, okay? Like a black woman, you know? She's talking shit about his prophet.
I, the Lord, Yahweh, will make myself known unto him in a vision, and I will speak unto him in a dream.
Yeah, so that's normally how the Most High deal with the prophet. He speaks to us in vision over a dream. Go ahead.
My servant Moses is not so, yeah. Who is faithful in all mine house.
Yeah, he said, my servant Moses, I'm gonna tell you, I speak to him directly, man. Me and him have been talking together. We have a conversation, man. Unlike the prophets of the old, when the Lord would speak to him through an angel, or through a vision, or a dream, I speak to him. Go ahead. I'm gonna tell you.
With him, I speak mouth to mouth.
Mouth to mouth, man. Okay, go ahead.
Even apparently, and not in dark speeches, and in similitude of the Most High, shall ye behold. Wherefore then were ye not afraid to speak against my servant Moses?
Yeah, so they should have been scared. But we're giving you the reason why Miriam was struck from another student. Basically, she looked like a so-called woman. Okay, when you read it, she got struck looking like an Edomite, man. Okay? And that's because you don't talk against the Most High servant. You know, nowadays we're living in a time where people, they talk against us all the time. They're on the internet, they face to face, because they don't have no fear of the Lord, man. Well, back then, people had a fear of Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai, man. Okay?
And the anger of Yahweh was kindled against them, and he departed, and the cloud departed from off the tabernacle, and behold, Miriam became leprous.
Yeah, Miriam became leprous.
White as snow,
and that's not talking about white snow. We're talking about Edomite. We're gonna get it. I'll show you. When you look at the word Numbers 12 and 10. Okay. Because to look like an Edomite, that's not the thing to the Most High, man. The Most High doesn't, you know, like in this society, we're taught that to look like an Edomite, a so-called white man, woman, or child, that's the pinnacle of beauty, man. Blonde hair, blue eyes, pale skin, red skin, that's supposed to be the hallmark of beauty, but that's really the hallmark of a curse, man, okay? So this is Numbers. Verse 10, that word for leprous. That word for leper is tazara, okay? And it says to be diseased of skin, to be leprous, to be a leper, to have leprosy. It says, Tazaraya.
The only reason that people think that's beauty is because of the TV, because the media is always pushing models, white models, everything. The soap operas, even in the Northern Kingdom, if you haven't, the soap operas are one of the main actors, people that look like Edomites. So that's like what they push forward to look like, oh, that's the models. If you look at Victoria's Secret and all that shit, most of them are Edomites.
Yeah.
And they put like one or two like colored skin women just to people and say, oh, they're racist.
God.
That's what I try to do.
But in the ancient world, if you look like an Edomite, man, it was a curse, man. Yeah. People stayed away from you, man. People ran away from you, man.
Imagine. Everybody having pigmentation and out of nowhere a fucking Edomite comes, everybody be like, yo, what the fuck?
Yeah, you got our people, you got our, especially in the men's, especially over there in Jamaica, man. They love to put on that bleak skin, man. That bleak to white up their skin, man. Okay? Why is that? Because they've been taught through this slavery, okay? That to look like an Edomite is to look like, handsome, man. Like when they say tall, dark, and handsome, they apply that to an Edomite with dark hair. Okay? That, in the ancient world, it applied a dark skinned man, a brown skinned man, with black woolly hair, man. Because you were taller back then, man. So that word, like the knight in shining armor, man, it was usually a black man, okay? Not a fucking Edomite, man. But now we live in a time where to look like an Edomite, every hey, man, hold that, and go to Isaiah chapter 20.
The book of Isaiah, chapter 29, verse 16. Surely your turning of things upside down shall be esteemed as a potter's clay, for shall the works. For shall the works say of him that made it, he made me not? Or shall the thing formed say of him that formed it, he had no understanding?
Yeah, that's what the so-called white man says about the Most High, man. God doesn't exist. He didn't make me. He formed me out of, I was born out of a amoeba, out of the water, and climbed out of the water and evolved into this human, which that's nothing but Darwinism, when that was created. Even Darwin said when he's on his deathbed that there isn't God, man, okay? And on top of that, you know, he makes it seem like, oh, look, like, I'm the quintessential smart hallmark, like I said, quintessential hallmark of beauty. It's me, I'm in myself, that proud self, man. So again, the point of the matter is, surely you're turning the things upside down as being seen as the product of play. So here it is, good is turning evil. Evil is turning to good. So-called, looking like a so-called white man, Edomite. That's beauty. And looking like a so-called Negro, but looking at Egypt, but you know what it is, right? That's why I people and all people across the world want to look like a white man. You go to Korea, them Koreans, they're bleaching their skin to get whiter and lighter, okay? You go to Africa, they're doing the same goddamn thing. You go all over the world, you look at, every time you open up a magazine or you look at a billboard, you see a leopard. And you're like, oh man, that's beautiful, man. Women, they want to get blonde hair, blue eyes. They put that blonde weave in their hair. I saw a chick today, she, you know, a Jake woman. Okay, driving to the camp. When I was driving to camp, she was walking. You know, she looked decent on the outside, but she looked ugly on that head, man. And she had that blonde hair, man.
Yeah, you women should fucking know, like, if you have dark hair, you better do a treatment on your head. You gotta bleach and shit and basically kill the hair.
God,
like, you're fucking harming your head, harming your hair. You fucking look like an Edomite. Like, what the fuck?
That's right. So let's go back to numbers, man.
And the cloud departed from off the tabernacle, and behold, Miriam became leprous, white as snow. And Aaron looked upon Miriam, and behold, she was leprous.
Yeah, she was leprous, man. So he turned her from being a brown, dark-skinned woman to being a white woman, man. Let's see if Miriam liked that shit. Let's see if Miriam, Moses, or Aaron liked that. Like, that was an acceptable thing. Keep reading.
And Aaron said unto Moses, alas, my Lord, I beseech thee, lay not the sin upon us.
Yeah, that was a sin.
Wherein we have done foolishly, huh. And wherein we have sinned. Huh. Let her not be as one dead.
As one dead, man. And that's what you need in my truth, like. That, like, when I saw Esau was born, the devil, like, I saw. He looked like something that's half dead. What the fuck is wrong with this? What the hell? And don't say that two so-called black people can't give birth to an Edomite baby, man. Because you can, man. There's multiple examples of that, okay? Where you have two people of color giving birth to an albino or an Edomite looking baby, man. And sometimes it's not even albino. It didn't come out looking like an Edomite. And the other two ones come out looking like a dark-skinned baby, okay? So that's been happening since the beginning of time, man. Okay? Keep reading, bro.
Let her not be as one dead.
Let us not be as one dead, man. And these Edomites, you walking around here, you're dead, man. You look dead, man.
That's right.
To the Most High, how about you know shot? There's nothing beautiful about an Edomite, man. First of all, like, that's a clean leper, man. This woman right here, she's a clean leper, man. Her head, she got blonde hair, that's a yellow thin hair, okay? That's a thin, wheat hair, okay? And then she got struck, on top of that, she got struck with leprosy, man. Okay? And when they get burnt, like you were talking about the sunburn, when that raw flesh pick up on the man out of the sun, guess what? Then they become unclean, man. Because that's an unclean flesh, man. What I have is leprosy, man. I have it in a spot, so it makes me unclean. But, hey, well, look, I'm in this fucked up body. Ain't nothing I can do about it, man. Okay? Just roll with the punches, man. Okay? But to look like an Edomite is not beautiful, man. You come out here, you'll see these goofs. These motherfuckers have umbrellas in the daytime, man, in the sunlight. Why? Because they're trying to protect their skin from the sunlight, man. Because they want to look as white as it can be, man. Because according to Japanese and Korean and Chinese women, to look like a white woman is acceptable, man. But to look like a so-called black man, woman, and child, that's unacceptable, man. You see the turning of things upside down? So let her not look as one dead. He reading.
Of whom the flesh is half consumed.
Whom the flesh is half consumed. So when you see a so-called white man, woman, and child, their flesh is consumed, man. No melanin, man. They look like they're about to give up the ghost, man.
That's right. When he cometh out of his mother's womb, yep. And Moses cried unto the Yahweh, saying, heal her now.
See, Moses didn't say, oh man, people looking like that, put her on posters. He was like, heal her now. Heal her now, Lord, please. He was crying to the Lord, man. Even though his sister and his brother were talking shit, hey, it was her ass that was talking the most shit, man. Like the scripture says, let not a woman usurp authority over a man. I suffer not a woman to usurp authority over a man. Okay? So she was trying to usurp her authority.
Isn't the Lord talking to me too?
No, he wasn't. And he's going to show you, he's showing you right now when he turned her into a leper, a white woman. He turned her into a white woman. Okay? Right. That was unacceptable, man. That was a curse. Go ahead.
For now, O Yahweh, I beseech thee, the Moses, if her father had spit in her face, should she not be ashamed?
Yeah, she
7
been,
days?
Yeah, she should have been ashamed. So the Most High made her ass ashamed, man. Okay?
Right.
Go ahead.
Let her be shut out from the camp 7 days and after let her receive in again.
Yeah.
And Miriam was shut out from camp 7 days. Then the people journeyed not. Miriam was brought in again.
Yeah, you can stop right there. So here, the be out there with, okay? Here, people and shit look like a white woman. Outside the camp, she moved until she regained her complexion again, man. So to look like a so-called white man, woman, and child, that's a curse, man.
That's right.
Okay, that's not beautiful, okay? That's not acceptable, okay? And that's according to the Bible, okay? Let's go back to Genesis.
This is the book of Genesis, chapter 25, verse 26. And after that, came his brother out, and he had a seal.
Notice they didn't give the complexion of his brother. Why? Esau said normal, man. Esau was only anomaly, man. He was only in the armor, man. Okay? So to look like an Edomite, that's the curse, man. And why are we saying that? Let's stop there. We're going to go to, stop right there. We're going to go to, Holy. Let's go to Leviticus. Hey, you know people like this.
Now when we talk about the so-called white man, not everybody that looks like a white person is going to eat a white man.
But the point of the matter is that who's oppressing us? The children of Israel and the children of Judah, who's oppressing us? So what? You don't want this world. Yeah, all these people, all these people are false prophets. Okay, because they're
the Dalai Lama. Yeah.
Right, because they don't worship.
It's ego based.
Yeah, they don't worship. And the scriptures say pride is the beginning of sin.
Revelation about a year and a half that terrified me. Yeah. Something told me, it's almost like a clarion.
No, if you read the scripture, you say, oh, yeah, this is the old enemy, because it's talking about the stuff that the Most High brought on. It's talking about how the Most High took his own people from whatever.
And Isaac was 80 years old when she bare them.
Now let's stop right there, and we're going to go to Leviticus chapter 14. I'm sorry, 16. And I'm going to show you where to start. Leviticus chapter 16. We'll start at 16 and... Yes, 13. Let's start at start at 9.
The book of Leviticus, chapter 13, verse 9. When the plague of leprosy is in a man, then shall he be brought unto the priest. And the priest shall see him, and behold, if the rising be white in the skin, and it have turned the hair white, then there be quick raw flesh in the rising, it is an old leprosy in the skin of his flesh, and the priest shall come. And the priest shall pronounce him unclean.
Yes.
And shall not shut him up.
So this is going to be a diagnosis for leprosy. Okay, a diagnosis for looking like a so-called white man, woman, or child, a red devil. Okay, this is a leprosy because, and it also shows you that the Israelites are people of color, man. Okay, they're not the Israelis over there calling themselves Jews today, man. What you got are people scattered among those two. But those people that keep doing that, they're not the children of the Lord, man. Because look, if he got struck with leprosy, he would look like a so-called white man. There was no reason to admit it or to prescribe a cure for it, man. So let's read.
And if the leprosy break out abroad the skin, and the leprosy cover all the skin of him that hath the plague, from his head even to his foot, wheresoever the priest looketh, then the priest shall consider, and behold, if the leprosy have all his flesh, he shall pronounce him clean.
Yeah, so he shall pronounce him a clean leper. Now, does that mean that he's supposed to be clean, he could just come up in here? No, he's just a clean leper, man. Like the so-called white man, he's a clean leper. Like what I would be considered would be an unclean leper because I have an espoused, okay? But the point of the matter is that Esau, he's a clean leper, okay? From his head to his feet. Hold on, says in people malignant skin disease, man. So malignant means that they have lack of melanin, man. Okay, now when you look at the so-called white man, like you were saying, he has a lack of melanin, and then they got that blonde hair. They have a lack of melanin in their scalp, in their hair. Okay, that's why they got that thin yellow hair. Okay, so that's telling you that the children of Israel are people of color, man. They gotta be, and they still are today. And we're spread among the other nations, so you got Israelites that look like Edomites, and you got Edomites that look like Israelites. Due to confusion of faces, but the point of the matter is, we're breaking down what leprosy is, man.
But when the raw flesh appeareth in him, he shall be unclean.
So that raw flesh is, like we were speaking earlier, that raw flesh is like when you get sunburned, and they got that raw red flesh on them, and it's peeling, it starts to peel, then he's unclean. Okay, so he goes from a clean leper to an unclean leper, okay? And this is something that, this is a punishment of judgment that would strike Israelites too, man, okay? But back then, we had the cure. Yahweh Bashim, Yahweh Shai, the prayers of the priest, okay? We'll get the melanin back.
And the priest shall see the raw flesh and pronounce him to be unclean. For the raw flesh is unclean.
Yeah,
it is leprosy.
And
For if the raw flesh was turned again and be changed unto white, he shall come unto the priest, and the priest shall see him, and behold, if the plague be turned into white, the priest shall pronounce him clean that hath the plague, he is clean.
That's right. So if it goes away, you pronounce it, and he's clean, man.
The flesh also, in which even in the skin thereof was vile, and is healed, and in the place of the vile there be a white rising, or a bright spot white, and somewhat reddish, and it be shown to the priest. And if when the priest seeth, behold, it be in sight lower than the skin, and the hair thereof be turned white, the priest shall pronounce him unclean.
Right.
It is a plague of leprosy broken out of the bile.
Right. And so that's that like the brother was going into. You have the I think it's epidermis, the outside, on top, and the dermis, the lower dermis. And if that lower dermis, there's a fat over it. That's why somebody say, oh, you got fat to the white meat. If you ever get a scar or a fat, when you beat your skin, you notice it don't bleed right away. It's like white. And then blood starts flowing through it. Yeah, that's the effect to the white. Which is really that fat underneath the dermis. That's why when it's so far white, then when they're not standing outside in front of the sun, okay, it might be cold or something like that. It gets a little cool color. Now you're looking at that white fat gelatin that's underneath the dermis. Underneath the epidermis, okay? But when it gets hot, blood starts flowing through that area, or he gets frustrated, or you smack him, all this shit. As that blood starts flowing through that area, man. Okay? But they tell you to take a look. The first word for a blind mind stuff. You got a nice body, but she's a leper, and she got blind hair, man. That's a blind mind stuff. Or a brunette. She a leper, but her scalp is not leper. But she gets a clean leper. And they said, oh, that's blinds have more fun than brunettes. That's what they say, right? But really, hey, blondes got it worse than brunettes, man. She's a green leper all off the scalp to toe, man. See? Go ahead, bro.
But if the priest look on it, and behold, there be no white hair therein, and if there be not, Salakia, and if there be not lower than the skin, but be somewhat dark, then the priest shall shut him up 7 days.
Yep. So let's jump. We're gonna jump down real quick. Let's go to
Leviticus chapter 13, verse 30. Then the priest shall see the plague, and behold, if it be in sight deeper than the skin, and there be in it yellow thin hair.
Thin yellow hair, like her, that blonde hair. That's leprosy of the scalp. Keep reading. What it say? Let's see if it says it's Maybelline. Well, let's see if it's beautiful, man. Keep reading.
And there be in it a yellow thin hair,
or so-called blonde, okay, go ahead.
Then the priest shall pronounce him unclean.
Oh, unclean, man. You're not the top of the food chain. You're the bottom of the food chain, man. And here it is, the Lord gives you an example, an express example about it, from your head to your toes to your feet, okay? Everything, man.
Even your spirit, he's you're fucking condemned, man.
Hey, you're done from the outside in, man. These niggas raw, uncompleted, man. Like the elder said, Ainot said on the sermon board, everything is turned upside down and put inside letters. This is the word broken. Out again, man, because the elder put out, that's the spirit, man, because everything here is turned upside down, man. Everything up here is inside out, outside in, okay. What is not supposed to be that way, man, okay.
The book of Isaiah chapter 29 verse 16, surely your turning of things upside down shall be esteemed as the potter's clay.
Yeah, you turn everything upside down, man. Everything that's adverse to Yahweh Bashanah was shot, you made good. Everything that goes against the law, statutes, commandments of Yahweh Bashanah was shot, you made acceptable, man. You made looking like a so-called white man, an Edomite, acceptable. You made homosexuality, lesbianism, acceptable. Earlier on, you had two unclean lepers walking down the street holding each other's hand, women. Yikes, man. You made that acceptable, man. You made lies true and true lies, man. Okay?
For shall the word say of him that made it, he made me not?
Yeah, and that's what you Edomites do. You all be talking about science, false, so-called. Okay? You say that Charles Darwin's theory of evolution is the hallmark of creation. Okay? You say that there's... Hey, you even say that there's no God, man. All the while, you worship Satan.
The only thing that science is basically a way for you to try to explain how things were made. Like, you weren't there, like it says in the book of Job. Were you there when I created the foundations of the earth?
That's right.
Tell me, because if you are so, you've been here plenty of days, probably paraphrasing.
That's right, man.
But yeah, you weren't here. How are you going to know how everything was made?
That's right, man. And here it is, the Lord gave you a written explanation about it, which is in the Bible, the scriptures, and you try to denounce that. You put a science falsely so-called over the word, okay? Everything that's evil has become good. Real quick, this is Isaiah 5 and 20. Woe to them that call evil good and good evil, that put darkness for light and light for darkness, that put bitter for sweet and sweet for bitter. Okay, and that's what you do down here, man. Here it is, you had that devil come up here, try to put a curse on me, talking about something in the name of Jesus. That ain't even the Lord's name, man. The Lord's name is Yahweh Shai. Ain't no power in the name of Jesus. That ain't his name. No one ever called Yahweh Shai Jesus when he walked the earth. The Lord never created a first begotten son named Jesus. But you put that name over Yahweh Shai. You say Yahshua, instead of saying Yahweh Shai. See, you say God instead of saying Yahweh. You disrespect the Most High. You say there is no God, then you say if there is a God, he looks like you. Here's the proof. Here's the proof. Here's the proof. Hold on. One more.
Well, that image of him was supposed to be God touching Adam.
Yeah.
Fucking naked and shit.
Like, blasphemy, man.
Fucking.
It's right here.
Sexual. Jesus fucking done.
It's right here. Okay?
That's right!
That is double got to go, man. Okay? Here it is, like we were saying to that one woman, hey, all the wickedness Esau done perpetrated on the earth, you done destroyed this, you done trusted to the children of Israel, man. You done enslaved this, and you make a mockery of that. You took our heritage, you make a mockery of that. Okay? You took our word, the Bible, and you made a mockery of that. Went across the world, trying to colonize the world and the plantation of Christianity, man. Huh? God loves everybody. He's a white man. He's a soft-spoken individual. He only loves. He don't hate. You know? And what is Christianity done to 2.2 billion people on the earth, man? Mainly to the children of Israel. Made them more confused and dead than they are, man. Okay?
Or shall the thing framed say of him that framed it, he had no understanding?
Yeah, that's what you do, man. Oh, God don't know. Mother Nature. You attribute everything to Mother Nature. Who the fuck is Mother Nature, man?
Right.
Mother Nature don't exist. They don't create the heaven. It was the Most High Yahweh that created it. It was Son Yahweh Shai that created everything, man. That you see and you don't see, man. It was Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shai. That's at the bounds of the earth, man. He got it so that the water don't go past a certain crest of the sin. He got it so that the sin won't go past a certain crest of the water. And it does that on its own. What you attribute that to? Okay? Here it is, you had that damn wretched dog, Stephen Hawking, die last week. Everybody making a big deal about him. Oh, he's the smartest man in the earth. If he's so damn smart, why he couldn't get out that wheelchair?
Right.
Why couldn't he correct his speech? Huh? 36 years, he was caught up in that chair? And they make a movie about this nigga and they give a fucking tranny the award for it, man. And this place you gotta go, man. They gotta get this water out your bag, bro.
Yeah.
Oh, you can speak, bro.
I'm trying to get that preset in go.
Yeah, man. Okay? You Edomites just got that inner power in the mid, the late 15th century, man, 1492. And then you come up with some damn so-called Renaissance, man. The Age of Enlightenment. For who? Because we was already enlightened, man. It was the Age of Enlightenment for you Edomites. Coming out of the Caucasus Mountains, man. They coming back in the power,
quick.
This is the book of Job, chapter 38.
I'll start at the top.
Then Yahweh answered Job out of a whirlwind and said, who is that darkened counsel by words without knowledge? Gird up now thy loins like a man, for I will demand of thee, and answer thou me. Where was thou when I laid the foundations of the earth?
Yeah, you over here questioning the Lord, and that's really talking, because it's talking, this angel through the spirit of power of Yahweh, by Shem Yahweh Shai, speaking to Job, telling him to gird himself up like a man. Don't complain, okay? Don't complain about the condition that you're in, okay? Because, hey, I got everything, man. Where were you at? And likewise for Esau, to Edom, where were you at, man? Go ahead, let's read that.
Declare, if thou hast understanding, who hath laid the measures thereof, if thou knowest? Or who hath stretched the lines upon it? Whereupon are the foundations thereof fastened? Or who laid the cornerstone thereof?
That's right. You didn't do that, Esau. You didn't. You wasn't there doing the foundation of the earth, building it, refining it, okay? Concubine. You wasn't there refining it, doing nothing.
That's right.
But here it is, you're gonna try to remake the world in your own image, man. Which is your image, is the image of wickedness, man. That's why everybody's suffering. That's why the world's suffering, the earth's suffering, man. Shit, even the trees are suffering, man. Huh? Hey, the so-called white man, you're nothing but a walking plague, man.
That's right.
Everywhere you colonize, you brought diseases, man. Here in Hawaii, you brought diseases to these damn Japhites, man. You brought diseases to the Gadites and the Reubenites. To the Judites. All you do is bring disease and death, man. You're a walking plague, man. You can't do right. You add verse to the life itself, man.
All right, let's jump off.
When the morning stars sang together, and all the sons of Yahweh shouted for joy. Or who shut up the sea with doors when it break forth as if it had issued out of the womb? When I make the clouds the garment thereof, and thick darkness and swaddling band for it, and break up for the Shalakia, and break up for it my decree place, and set bars and doors, and said, hitherto shalt thou come, but no further.
Yeah, see, say that again. Now break up for the.
And
I. Yeah, hey, that's right, you told me. And we were prayer, but it's not early. We did, but.
11?
Yeah, read 11.
And said, hitherto shalt thou come, but no further.
Yeah, that, and that's why when you go to the ocean, it goes, it only goes a certain level, and then it goes right back. It retreats back into the ocean, man. Why is that? Because that was the decree by the Most High. Yahweh by Shem Yahweh Shai.
And there shall thy broad waves be stayed.
Yep. And that's why when I go to the ocean, man, I always look at it like, bro, it's so beautiful, man. The Most High created this, man. The air is created, the earth, Eden, the earth is Aidan, okay? To be a paradise, man. And then the so-called white man gets it in his grubby hands and he destroys the earth, man. And then he takes everybody's culture, man. He doesn't but a culture, but you're a piece of shit, man. You eat him as a piece of shit, yo.
That's right.
You so-called white people, man. You're the worst humans, you're the worst of base humans on the earth, man. You're not even a human, because you don't have any color. You are the worst, man. You're the worst of the worst, man. You're the worst of the worst. But then you say, we're the worst of the worst, man. Oh, all we do is rob and steal. But you put that shit in the ghetto, man. You got gun stores. You got liquor stores. You don't want to run in state stores. The state stores are ran by the government. Check cashing places all over the goddamn place. Pawn shops. But then you go to your neighborhood, it's quiet and serene and peaceful, man. You see these goddamn fucking these looking ass dukes to the ghetto to exploit us? Huh? Look at these people, man. The permanent Down syndrome. And then you act like you ain't no fucking victim. You act like you ain't the perpetrator, but you the victim. You Edomites are the worst. You so-called white people are the worst people on the earth, man.
That's right.
We fucking hate you Edomites, man. We fucking hate you Edomites, man. And you should be mad. You should be upset. Because it ain't us that did it. It was y'all. Colonization, destruction of the earth, destruction of space. It was y'all.
Go ahead, brother.
Hast thou commanded the morning since thy days, and caused the day spring to know his place, that it might take hold of the ends of the earth, that the wicked might be shaken out of it? It is turned as clay to the seal, and they stand as a garment. And from the wicked their light is withholden, and the high arm shall be broken.
That's pretty much it right there, man. So let's go back to Genesis, bro. What you have before that? Yes, and let's go back to Genesis.
27.
Yeah. The book of Genesis, chapter 25, verse 27. And the boys grew, and Esau was a cunning hunter.
Yeah, and cunning means very, very sly, very, very, very tricky. And when Esau goes out to hunting, this dude, he'll dress up like a bunch. He'll use a duck call just to get a duck to come by so he can shoot it. You'll go out to the African safari, kill a big ass elephant for no reason. Hey, during the time of the Indian Removal Act, you was killing all the bison so you can deplete the Gadites and the Reubenites and the Israelites' food supply. And you just killed them. You wasn't eating it. You wasn't wearing a fur for clothes. You just killed them, man. They got pictures of mountains and mountains of that shit, man. Okay? And you'll dress up like a mud, you'll dress up like a scenery, man. You Edomites, man. You create camouflage.
even put the excrement of the animals on top of them so that they don't smell their human
stench.
Yeah, that's right.
The Edomite stench, man. Because animals, they can pick up on that shit, man. As soon as your funky ass go to the woods, man. So that's talking about two Edomites, man. Read that again.
And the boys grew, and Esau was a cunning hunter, a man of the field.
Yeah, a man of the field, and that's what you Edomites are. You love to be in the field, you love to be in the wilderness, you love to sleep outside, okay? You go into the most remote area on the earth, and you'll stay there, hunt, hide, okay? You love to live in the caves, you love rock climbing. That's you Edomites, man. Go ahead.
And Jacob was a plain man dwelling in tents.
Yeah, Jacob's a plain man. All we like to do is you just date a woman, some good drink, and he's chilling at the house, man. You can always find Jacob at the crib, man. We don't even like going outside that much, man. We might go outside, go get a breath of fresh air, man. But that's about it. We back at the house, man. Hey, where you everything else, Jacob? Where you going? I'm going to the house, man. I'm going to the crib, man. Hey, you don't want to go? I got everything I need at the house, man. That's what Esau was doing. Hey, you wanna go out with me hunting? Come on, Jacob. Let's go out with me hunting, man. Nah, I'm cool. I'm gonna stay here and tend to the sheep, man. I'm gonna worship you. How about you down beside me? Hey, I'm good. Are you sure? I got all this crazy meat. Look, man, you can eat it raw. Look, I created something called jerky, but you didn't create jerky. What you said? Look. You just hang out with me, man. No, man, I don't wanna do that shit. Fuck out of here, bro. Go ahead, keep reading.
And Isaac loved Esau because he did eat of his bison.
His venison, which his mom taught him how to make. Which was a different, the deer he would catch. You know?
But Rebekah loved Jacob.
Yeah, she loved Jacob, man. And Jacob's a mama's boy to this day, man. Mama!
And Jacob sought pottage, and Esau came from the field, and he was faint.
Yeah, so here it is, he was out hunting. He ain't getting up here all day, okay? So he was like, look, man, I need to eat. I'm a god, no faith. And he knew Yahweh, he knew the name, because Isaac knew the name. But he didn't, but what you do? Instead of being patient and waiting for the food, you couldn't keep eating.
And Esau said unto Jacob, feed me, I pray thee, with that same red pottage.
And how we know it was uncooked meat? Real quick, this is Hebrews 12 and 16. Hebrews 12 and 16. Hebrews 12 and 16. Hebrews 12 and 16. Lest there be any fornicator or profane person as Esau, who for one morsel of meat sold his birthright, man. So that red pottage was uncooked meat, man. And how does Esau like to eat his meat? Rare, medium rare, bloody rare, blue, steak tartare.
That's right.
You still eat raw meat to this day. You and your kind. And you taught the world to do the same thing. You taught the Israelites to do the same thing, man. Okay?
For I am faint, therefore was he named Salakia. Therefore was his name called Edom.
Edom, bread, man. Which is bread.
And Jacob said, sell me this day thy birthright. And Esau said, behold, I am at a point to die.
Yeah, no faith, impatient. And when you see the so-called white man today, he's impatient. He don't have no faith. He don't believe in the Lord. You ain't got no heart for the Lord, man. Look, man, every place is sick, man. Keep reading, bro. Only in Esau society, man. They just had two Jakes walking up the street, two male men holding hands, two women. Now you got two dykes, you got a woman dressed like a man. And who set that up? The white man, yo. You Edomites, bro. You the fucking devil, man. Look at you, man. All the women is your forefathers
did.
You are the fucking devil. You are, man. You are the fucking devil, man.
And what profit shall the birthright do to me?
Yeah, he didn't even care about his birthright. But then he cried about it two chapters later, man.
Is the nigga proud about it, man? What about me? Is he not rightly called Jacob, the supplanter? He took my birthright, now he's taking my blessing too? You a liar!
That's right!
You hear my bunch of liars, man! You so-called white people, man!
And Jacob said, swear to me this day, and he swore to him, and he sold his birthright unto Jacob. Then Jacob gave Esau bread and pottage of lentils, and he did eat and drink, and rose up and went his way.
Yeah, he didn't care. He didn't care. He was like, oh man, I'm good now. He just satisfied his appetite for the moment, and he just walked off, man. Was he arguing with Jacob saying,
nah, man, you gotta put
me in my birthright? He's like, man, I don't care. What are you gonna do with me? I'm starving right now. I'm hungry right now. How's it gonna help me? He didn't even call on the Lord, man.
That's right.
No faith, man. Because you're a carnal man, yo. You're a carnal beast, man. And your children today, they're the same way you were in the ancient world, man. And they like to point each other out. But you eat them like you so-called white people. The reason why you're able to walk around the earth and to do the things you're doing is because of what your forefathers done, man. What your forefathers do. You done took over nations, took their lands, created new lands, created land borders.
Right.
You did that, man. Hey, look at Hawaiian history, man. I'm not even Hawaiian. But just look at their history, man. How the white man became the power behind the throne, man. Huh? And then took their land and then colonized these people, man. And these Japanese, so damn slow and dumb, they didn't even fight, man. They didn't even fight. Even if they'd have fought, they'd have lost, but they didn't even fight. Culture appropriators, man. Culture vultures, man. Culture fucking vultures, man. White women walk down the street with cornrows in their hair, it's beautiful. Black girl walk down the street with cornrows in their hair, that nappy-headed black bitch. You see?
Right.
You see? The hypocrisy. And you're walking hypocrisy, man. You're walking hypocrisy. Nobody likes to hear that. But the Lord speaks against you, man. Your whole actions weigh against you, man. You weigh your hands in the earth by violence, man. This is a violent man. But he don't want you to get violent with him. See? Drop that and get a. Let's go to Isaiah 35 and start at the top.
Man, that's just Esau's spirit. Like, he always want to take shit because he doesn't want to do it himself. Like, I'm pretty sure it says he was a great hunter, so he knew how to get easy food. You got me?
Yeah.
So, but he just saw that Jacob had something. He was just like, you know what? Give it to me now.
Yeah, he didn't want to wait because he was
basically
waiting. Yeah, he was impatient. He was waiting all day. And sometimes you do that. You go out hunting and you don't find nothing. And then you come back hungry, starving. So I don't know how long the nigga was out there. But whatever he gave, he couldn't wait for that food to be made. So much so that he got his brother to give him some raw meat. And I know his brother looking like, what? And he said, therefore his name was called Edom. You know, Jacob do that. Jacob stopped calling you a nickname for some wild shit you done did, man. Or it's some freak boy. Edom. Look at Edom. Look at Idawamu.
Nice.
Oh, stop calling me Idawamu. My name's Esau. Mom and dad named me Esau. And he's like, nah, nigga, you ate that raw ass meat, man. And you know we don't eat that shit.
Right. This is the book of Isaiah, chapter 35, verse 1. The wilderness and the solitary place shall be glad for them.
Hey man, like I said, we're just doing the basics, man. We point out Esau, okay? Bringing out who Esau is, why his name is called Edom, okay? His name is Edom because he's red. Red shows forth through his skin, okay? His name is Esau because he was wasted away when he was born. And we gave you some of his attributes. He's impatient, he likes raw meat. He's a man in the wilderness. He's violent, okay? So now we're gonna give you some judgment that's gonna befall him, man.
This is the book of Ezekiel, chapter 35, verse 1. Moreover, the word of Yahweh, yep. Son of Man, set thy feet against
capital, in Edom, man. That land in southwest of Israel, man. And you know he look like that dude so for real, man. That ain't him. He's like this dude that comes up against
him. Yeah, I see. Cars.
Yeah. Go ahead.
And prophesy against it.
So we're prophesying against you through the spirit power of Yahweh Bashi now with Shai, man. Hey, because none of those the destruction of Edom hasn't happened yet. Nowhere in history can you point that out, man. But you got the fact like Bo Gam Malone and say, oh, that already happened. Or Jesus is the word, or faith to the devil, or say that all those people from the ancient world are born, now we're dealing with the new people. Who the fuck are the new people? Where they come from? Okay. See? But they got different names because the Esau is the moment, you know?
And say unto it, thus say Yahweh power, behold, O Mount Seir, I am against thee, and I will stretch out mine hand against thee. And I will make thee most desolate.
Yeah, he said he's gonna make thee most desolate. He's not talking about Georgia. That's where Mount Seir adventure is today. He's talking about America, man. He's gonna stretch out his hand, he's gonna make this place most desolate. How is he gonna do it? By nuclear fire. Keep reading, bro.
I will lay thy cities waste, and thou shalt be desolate, and thou shalt know that I am Yahweh.
Yeah, both sides gonna lay your cities waste. Baltimore, Philadelphia, New York, Honolulu, Los Angeles, San Francisco, Oakland, okay, what else? Boston. All your major cities, D.C., Chicago, Indiana, Indianapolis, all of that's going to be destroyed by nuclear fire.
Because thou hast had a perpetual hatred and hast shed the blood of the children of Israel by the horse of the sword in thine, Salakia, by the force of the sword in the time of their calamity.
And this is a perpetual hatred, man. When they was hanging you, okay, this is after slavery, man. This is post-slavery, man. Jim Crow era, okay? They putting you on reservation, starving you out. That's a perpetual hatred. Not making any mention of you, unless it's to exploit you. That's a perpetual hatred. You've always had a hatred since we were reading about Esau. When you lost that birthright, man. After you lost that birthright and then you lost the blessing, you were upset. But you don't know that the birthright was never yours. Neither was the blessing, man. The scripture said the elder shall serve the younger. Who is the elder? Esau. So you were always going to be a perpetual slave to Jacob and his children and his brothers. Okay? You and your brothers, man. But this is a perpetual hatred. But every time we bring it up, you see how nobody making a big deal about this shit? That's everybody's right. Walking by like, oh, it's whatever. But let these jakes have been some Polynesians or some goddamn gooks. Oh, man, all hell would have broke loose, man.
Right.
Okay? But for us, no hate. But this is a perpetual hatred. Start that again.
Because thou has had a perpetual hatred.
Yeah, and none of these dudes went to jail. None of these dudes suffered persecution or prosecution. Nobody cares. And that's what makes you so mad sometimes, bro. A lot of you think you should be mad, but you're still being hung. You being hung physically in that courtroom, that kangaroo court system. But the white man can walk by and just smile. Oh, this was nothing. Who cares about these niggas hanging on a rope? Okay? That's the mentality. See? This is wrong. We're pointing out to say that it was wrong. Okay, this is a perpetuation.
We're going back there.
Oh, yeah, you're right. Yeah, you're right. That's right, you see? All right, I'll take that. He might be an Israelite. But he's real, he's true. The Edomites are fucked. They're going back to that. Because we're not going to go through this again. Affliction shall not rise a second time. Buddy. After this big massive race riot that happened, this race war that happened in America, and America was destroyed, we're not gonna go through this, but you Edomites are gonna go through this. You're fucked, man. Like the dude said. I didn't say that, he said it. Yeah, go ahead.
And has shed the blood of the children of Israel.
All the children of Israel, man. Hold that. I gotta read this real quick. Hold that. This is Jeremiah 15:33. Jeremiah 15:33. And you can break this down. Go ahead. book. This Jeremiah 15:33. Thus says the Lord of hosts, the children of Israel and the children of Judah were oppressed together. And all that took them captive held them fast, they refused to let them go.
That's right, and that's talking about the slavery when the Spaniards came to the South Americas and they brought the tribes of Judah into the North Americas, and they still have us here today, oppressed together, the Northern and the Southern Kingdoms.
Right here. You see, like the brother was saying, colonized all of them, Columbus, and Judah too. So we're oppressed together.
Still oppressing us mentally and physically also. It's just that you do it voluntarily.
God, man. Wisdom and oppression is very day, man. You see, the fact that the white man can sit and laugh at us, smile on our face, this is murder. And your forefathers did this, man. Yeah, he don't give a fuck, man. Sit here with a cigarette and poison us with his nicotine. We don't smoke.
Yo, look at the target.
You see?
I'm from Ireland, motherfucker.
Oh yeah, so some of the Irish are jakes. You know the real Irish were black people. The Scot, what does the word Scot mean? Black, man.
No.
Okay?
False.
Okay?
You're wrong.
No, you're wrong, man. You don't know anything about history, man. You know zero about history. So you trying to tell me that none of the Irish were black, whatever black. I can literally bring it out, but you don't want to hear it.
Show me.
Okay?
Show me Black Irish. Doing good?
Why are you smoking, man? You seem like killing yourself.
I didn't know that, yeah?
Okay. Well, let me poison yourself. So this is out of a book called The Negro Question Part 4, The Missing Link. The missing link. Okay? Okay. Here it is right here. African Americans with Scottish and Welsh and Irish last names. Benjamin Franklin goes on to say. Okay, it doesn't matter. I know Benjamin Franklin wasn't American. He actually was an Englishman. He came over to America with the rest of the colonizers. So I'm giving you history. That the Irish, the blacks were Irish, okay, and you got our people that look like you, but you're still Israelites. That's why when you look at the bottom here, I got on the bottom Irish and Italian. Because a lot of those Irish, despite Irish, they were Israelites, man. And they are today. You just look like you're white people today. Because of misogynation and mixing, man. Okay, so here it goes, it says Benjamin Franklin goes on to say that why should these swarthy Tony or black Germans, Italians, Spaniards, Russians, Swedes be deported to Pennsylvania colonies. He further stated that they cannot obtain our complexion all over the internet. There are articles asking the question, why do large percentage of African Americans have Scottish, British, and Irish last names? These surnames have been found in Pennsylvania, just like Benjamin Franklin stated, in a large number. You can find these last names in New York, Connecticut, Idaho, Tennessee, Delaware. And they all didn't come from being slaves, it says right here. Yeah, I'm about to say, it says, I have read the writings of the historians who have discovered that the phrase black Dutch is actually referring to the black Germans or swarthy Germans. They are getting close, but they too need the missing link. The Negro Question Part 4, the last names of these people, the DNA print left from bygone days when they were part of the three kingdoms, Britain, Ireland, and Scotland. Okay? And on top of that, King James. He was the king of Ireland, Scotland, and France. I know he was the king of England. He was a black man. And he first was the king of Scotland, man. And then he became the king of England and France after the Queen Elizabeth's death. Okay? There's some more information. It says it right here.
Hey, do you have a witness, please?
Yeah, I'm not. No, you're not being mean. I'm just giving you some information. I'm speaking. I'm not mad at you or nothing. I don't have any hostility towards you.
I'm sorry.
That's all right. That's your point, man. That's not our point. You know what I'm saying? It's okay. That's your point. So anyway, so here's a more. But Oliver Cromwell, he put a lot of people out. Here it is right here. This is a black man. An image location, Irish library, Irish history. The Irish rebellion, 1861. This is a black man. And they killed John too, doing a potato famine. Okay, and then you had to sign up for indentured servitude. Yeah, man, well, it ain't about being mean.
You're 100% right.
I know. Yeah. Hey, thanks for listening, bro. Hey, have a good day, man. All right.
The book of Ezekiel, chapter 35, verse 5. Because thou hast had a perpetual hatred and hast shed the blood of the children of Israel.
That's right, you had a perpetual hatred and you shed the blood of the children of Israel, man. Here's some symbols and signs of that right here. Okay? Right here, the so-called Native Americans, the Seminole Indians, the Gadites, you brought poison. Okay, here it is, you did all this to us, but you allow these fucking dupes to come over here and prosper. All the rest of these heathens to come over here and prosper. Okay? But you killed us and you murdered us. Why? Because you hate us, man. Even now, Trump wanted to deport the majority of the so-called Mexican people here in America. Why? Because he hates you. He don't like you. Huh? He want to put you niggas in the ghetto and kill you off. Why? Because he hates you. He don't like you. Because he's an Edomite. And all Edomites hate us and dislike us, man. They killed us with a sword. Read that again.
Because thou hast had a perpetual hatred and hast shed the blood of the children of Israel.
Yeah, you had a perpetual hatred and you shed the blood of the children of Israel, all the 12 tribes, man. I don't care how much they try to defend you, how people try to defend you, you're a murderer, man. And you got a lot of blood on your hands, the blood of the Israelites, the blood of the saints, man. Not just from the transatlantic slave trade, not just from the colonial period, but going all the way back from Cain and Abel.
By the force of the sword in the time of their calamity.
Yeah.
In the time that their iniquity had an end.
Yeah, our iniquity had an end after slavery was over, man. After chattel slavery was over, after you done conquered the Native Americans, you were supposed to let us go, man. But you didn't do that. Let us go. You so-called Negroes, Latinos, and Native Americans, man. Huh? Yeah, we're in slavery to the
Negroes.
Because it's our book. That's why. It's your book. Hey, the Most High.
Who's the Most High?
The one you call God, Yahweh. Who is the Yahweh? Yahweh. Is the name of the Lord.
Look at this nigga.
He's not a nigga, man. He's an Israelite, man.
You're a black Israelite.
No, he's not a black Israelite. Does he look black to you, man? He's like a so-called Latino. Huh? Yeah, I know that. That's what I'm saying. I say he's not black, man. He's an Israelite. I'm an Israelite. You're an Israelite.
He's black.
He's not black. Your head is black.
What color is
this? It's a shade of brown. 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 It's a shade of brown.
Right, brother?
You was in the oven. Hey, it's all right. I got a little bit more melanin. That's all, brother. We already telling our people that we're the Israelites of the Bible. We're not black Israelites. We're just Israelites. Black is a color. And it's actually a government term that was given to us by the government. Man. We're not black, man. We're the Israelites. You know what I'm saying? And we're telling our people. It's sackcloth, but it's really, this is our ancient garment. It's just our ancient garment. I got some shoes on, bro. So I don't walk around barefooted. You know what I'm saying? I don't want to walk around barefoot.
The book of Hosea, chapter 6, verse 6. Chapter 4, verse 6. My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge.
Hey, the Lord's people are destroyed for lack of knowledge. What they like, what we're talking but he ain't because the Lord blocked his mind. Okay? And you don't, and you know, they come up or anybody else come up, you don't got to get rowdy with them. They just speak out the book, man. Okay? Read again.
My people are destroyed for lack of knowledge because thou hast rejected knowledge.
Yeah, a lack of knowledge of what? Of Yahweh Bashi, Yahweh Shai. And he said, what did y'all read that Bible? Who wrote the Bible? He didn't even know. He don't know that the Bible is the word of the Most High.
Because thou has rejected knowledge.
Soon we start talking, oh, I gotta go, and I'm gone. And that's Jake, man. Jake is destroyed. So two-thirds of Israel, you're gonna die here on American soil and around the world. Tens of millions of Israelites are gonna be destroyed for a lack of knowledge, man. So you still got the knowledge of how to get out of this destruction, man. We got the Lord's name, the name of our power, Yahweh Bashim Awashai. We got the Lord's name to command so we can go back to our ways of our forefathers. And cling on to that. But you don't want it, so you're going to be destroyed. Keep reading.
I will also reject thee.
So the Most High rejected that nigga, man. Just like two-thirds of Israel, man. You rejected, man. You wonder why so many niggas is sticking all up in the church, man? Because they rejected, man. Why they blind to the fact? Because they rejected. Why they still worshiping a so-called white image of Serapis? Okay? Because they rejected, man. Why they into Islam, Buddhism, and everything else under the sun? Because they rejected. The Lord ain't dealing with you. Because you rejected him. Oh, nigga, get out that Bible out of here, man. Fuck that. I'm all about the K-Red. I'm all about the Egypt book of the dead. See?
That thou shalt be no priest to me, seeing thou hast forgotten the law of thy power.
Yeah, you're not going to be a priest to the Most High. First go around.
I will also forget thy children.
So that's why niggas are getting killed all up in the street. You all poor, dying. Okay, you all suffering in the ghetto. Huh?
That's right.
You all finished, man. Okay, you obsessed with brands. You finished. Okay? None of that's going to save you, man. Okay? I don't care how many times you go to Pastor Jenkins, or Pastor De La Cruz, guess what? He can't save you, man. You can't save yourself. He can't save himself, man. So you're going to be rejected. Your children are going to be destroyed because you rejected the Lord.
Chapter 35, verse 5. Because thou hast had a perpetual hatred and hast shed the blood of the children of Israel by the force of the sword.
And that's how you did it. The Gatling gun, red gun, sword. Hey, Christopher Columbus said he couldn't even put his sword down for a moment. It was so wet with blood, man. Keep reading, bro.
In the time of their calamity, in the time that their iniquity had an end.
Yeah, our iniquity had an end, our slavery, man. Because we went into hardcore slavery for our iniquities, man. We were allowed to be taken over by the Edomites for our iniquities, man. But our iniquity had an end. But you kept it going. Right now, to this day, we're in slavery. To this very day, we're in our captivity. When we're subject to payments. Okay? All our enemies are ruling over us. We haven't gotten any reciprocity. We got emancipated. We just got to trade it off, man. From the private sector to the state sector, man. Huh? We still under this white man's thumb, man. We have children. They're under the white man's thumb. They're slaves in the society. Huh? We're jacked up down here, man. So our iniquity had an end. Y'all should have let us go back to Israel, man. You should have told us, hey, y'all the Israelites. This is y'all book. Y'all go ahead and take that. Y'all go back to y'all land, man. But the white man was like, fuck that. You're going to be out playing for eternity, man. And I'm going to put these heathens over top of you. They're going to rule over you for eternity. And you're not an Israelite. You're an African-American. You're a Latino. You're Hispanic. You're a fucking Native American, man. That's what he said, right? Our iniquity had an end. We should have been out of this captivity, man. But we've been in the captivity so long, and we're just waxing worse and worse down here, man. That's why we need Yahweh Bashim, Yahweh Shai, bro.
That's right.
We need the Lord, man. We need him, man. Because we ain't got shit down here, man. We fucked up, man. We ain't got no continuing city. We don't got no land. We ain't got no army. We all jacked up. Most importantly, we didn't have our power until he came back to us, man. And gave us his word. He gave us his name. Now we being healed. But before that, it was over. Now, that's divine intervention, man. Because the white man wasn't going to tell you that. The white man kept telling you, oh, you're African American. Even we used to talk about black men. Oh, you're from Wakanda. You know, what kind of religion is this? Wakanda's a fake place. And we're not African. We're Israelites. But he said, oh, you're African. You put that African demon on you, man. Put that Latino demon on you, man. You're Hispanic. Where's the nation of Hispania? Please, somebody tell me so I can go get my Hispanic brother and sister.
That's right.
There's no place to be still. Okay? We, instead of y'all giving up, instead of y'all returning us back to our condition, y'all kept us here, man. And then when we get upset about being here, I'll go back to Africa. Get out of here. Go back to Spain. Hey, what's your nationality?
I'm Japanese and African.
What's your father?
African American.
Okay, so you're a Judah. What's your father?
My dad's white.
What, from like what? Irish, German, Italian?
It's like a mix, but mainly Irish.
Okay, so you guys are Israelites, man. That's your true nationality, that you're an Israelite. Your mother is a Japanese woman, an Ammonite. According to the Bible, her biblical nationality is that she's an Ammonite. And we're the Israelites, and we're telling all our people, because you'll be considered an Israelite of confusion of faith, because you look more like your mother than your father. You got your father's tint, okay, but you got your mother's hair, her eyes, her nose, and mouth. Okay, so, but you're an Israelite. Your nationality is you're an Israelite. That's what we're talking about.
It's only for you guys, not for anybody else.
That's right. It's time to wake up. Okay, so you're about to be saved out of this condition. You don't feel like you're in slavery. You're good. You're free. You got your friends. You're going to go hang out. But you got a social security card and a birth certificate, right? Those are called bond notes. And that the people that owns them are the Rockefellers and the Rothschilds, which are Edomite families, man. And they own you just like they own us, man.
Right.
And your nationality is your Hebrew Israelite, and your land is the land of Israel.
Therefore, as I live, saith Yahweh, I will prepare thee unto blood.
Yeah, so the Most High is going to prepare you Edomites unto blood, man. Go ahead.
And blood shall pursue thee.
So it's going to pursue you, man. We got to speak loud with a loud voice. That's why it's not yelling.
Since thou hast not hated blood.
Yeah, you don't hate blood. You go all across the world conquering people, tearing people up, taking their land, taking their resources, killing them, bombing them to hell and back. You don't even care about blood. You drink blood. Some of your elite, y'all, they drink blood. They worship Satan. All of that.
Right.
Since you ain't running from blood, blood's gonna pursue you, man. In the kingdom of heaven, the Most High is gonna pursue you with the sword, man. Through us, man. You can drop that. Go get a Jeep and turn about. You see, you don't like to talk about violence. But you perpetrate violence all throughout the earth, man. And we're making it plain, bro. We're making it plain. We're not lying. We're not doing it. We're just standing here with the Bible, talking. Worshiping the Lord at the altar. But you, when we talk about it, you get offended. Oh, this nigga said gun. Kill him. Oh, this nigga
said hate.
This nigga said hate. Kill him. Get him out of here.
That's right.
Okay? you reading that?
This is the book of Ezekiel, chapter 25, verse 12. Thus save Yahweh power, because that Edom hath dealt against the house of Judah.
Yeah, you dealt against the house of Judah, man. You see that? He's talking about Judah right now, but that goes for all of Israel, man.
By taking vengeance and have greatly offended.
Yeah, you took vengeance, man. That's what the whole slavery thing was about. Because we had them in slavery. Why they go straight from Judah, man? Soon as they got up in the power, the first people they went to was Judah, man. They got them off the thrones in Europe and in Germany and in Russia. Okay? You stole all our wealth and they threw us in slavery, man. Fuck that, we will get these niggas back. Then you went to the Americans and before you got Judah, you went to the Americans and they got the Northern people, man. Right? That was like what, 1492? And even before, prior to 1492, the Portuguese Edomites had Judah in slavery, man.
And have greatly offended and revenged themselves upon them. Therefore, saith Yahweh power, I will also stretch mine hand upon Edom.
Yeah, the Most High is going to stretch his hand upon Edom. And this can't happen yet, man. We're still waiting for this to happen. And you got stuff in the Old Testament that didn't happen yet, man. Like this. And go back to Numbers 24. None of that happened yet. So guess what? Keep reading, bro.
I will cut off man and beast from it.
So the Most High is going to cut off man and beast from it. Modern day East Edom, modern day East Edom, Seir, modern day Sodom and Egypt is America. You gonna cut everything off of him, man. Go ahead.
And I will make it desolate from Teman, and day of Dathan shall fall by the sword.
Yeah, you're gonna fall by the sword, man. Same sword that you pursued us with. Go ahead.
And I will lay my vengeance upon Edom.
He's gonna lay his vengeance upon Edom, the so-called white man, Edomites. Go ahead.
By the hand of my people,
by
Israel.
By the hand of his people, Israel. By the hand of his people, Israel. So you wanna know how you're gonna get judged? By Israel, man. Do you how about you how shut? And then we're gonna tear your ass up with the kingdom of heaven, man.
That's right!
You're not gonna make it. I don't know how the fuck you're gonna make it in 0.0 seconds, 0.00002 seconds of the kingdom of heaven, man. Cause soon as the Lord gives us that power and get us off these chains, we're gonna get loose on your ass, man.
That's right!
We're gonna get medieval on your ass, man. It's gonna be ugly out here, man. We're gonna make the transatlantic slave trade look like child's play according to the Most High.
That's right! And they shall do in Edom according to mine anger.
And we're going
to
do in Edom according to his anger, the Most High, Yahweh Shalom Shai. And the scripture said, hey, the Most High is angry with the wicked every day. So who is the wicked? The wicked, so far away from. And we're going to do in Edom according to his anger. So, you know, because Jake got a benevolent heart. Oh, don't go too hard on him, Kahan. Tearing him up, brother. Hey, Kahan, hey, brother, you're going off, man. Hey, you're going off. I'm going to do a 7-part series video on the brothers apart, man. Because he's talking about he want to go easy on the Edomites, man. Nah, man. So you don't never go easy on Edomites, the Most High going to put his anger on us, man.
Right, because our anger is not enough.
It's not enough, man.
And according to my fury, and they shall know my vengeance, saith Yahweh.
You going to know the Lord's vengeance, saith Yahweh, man. See, you don't know the Lord's vengeance yet. Has he been? So the brothers that's online, that's listening, here's a question that we're going to pose to you. And you can answer it with a yay or nay. Have the so-called white man paid for destroying the so-called Latin Native American tribes, man? That's a question to you. Has the so-called white man been paid back for what he did to the so-called Negro, West Indian, Haitian tribes of Judah, Benjamin, Levi? Has the so-called white man been paid back for stealing America from the tribes of Gad, Reuben, and Issachar? I wait. Hey, look, the answer's coming in at a steady pace, man. Hell no, no, nay, nay, none of that. So you ain't been paid back yet, bro. You a fugitive on the run. You a fugitive on the run. All it's a resounding no. It's a resounding nay. So you gonna know the judgment of the Lord when he put his home in you, man. And none of those two-thirds can jump in and help you, man. Ain't no speaker gonna help you, ain't no nigga gonna help you. You can run, you can try to run in front of the bullet all you want, you just gonna get cut. You just gonna get cut, you can run in front of the sword all you want, you just gonna get cut. Let me take the 421.
the book of Lamentations, chapter 4, verse 21. Rejoice and be glad, O daughter of Edom.
So what you should be doing before this ass whooping come to you, Esau, hey, you should just enjoy life, man. If you got credit cards, max them out. If you got a woman that you want to beat on and destroy, do what you got to do, man. Because it ain't, hey, you're not going to get another chance, man.
That's
if
right.
If you're an Edomite, here, March, if you're here and you're an Edomite in America on March 18th, 2018, you should be living it up, man. Like these Edomites out here right now, these Edomites, they're out here shopping, surfing, taking pictures and shit. Hey, all you Edomites in America and around the world, you should be doing this. If you're not doing this, there's a problem. Because you're never going to get another chance again.
That's right. Rejoice and be glad, O daughter of Edom.
Yeah, rejoice and be glad, man. That ass whooping ain't coming to you just yet, but it's coming. You better rejoice while you got a chance. Keep reading.
That dwellest in the land of Uz.
The modern day land of Uz is America. Go ahead.
The cup also shall pass through unto thee.
Now, brother, I got a question for you. What is that cup that's going to pass through unto them?
Cup of the wrath of Yahweh.
And what else?
That's right.
Slavery.
That
cup of slavery, man. That cup of the wrath. That's what it was. The reason why we went into slavery, both of us was in slavery. Okay? The reason why we went there, because of the wrath of the Lord. So you about to face the wrath of the Lord, man.
Thou shall be drunken and shall make thyself naked.
You're going to be drunk with slavery, man. You're going to be drunk with destruction. And you're going to make yourself naked. Meaning your wickedness is going to be shown, man.
That's right.
All the sins that you committed against the Most High is going to be shown.
The punishment of thine iniquity is accomplished.
So you so-called Negroes, Latinos, Native Americans, your punishment is accomplished. You're never going to go into slavery again, man. You're never going to be ruled over by your enemies again, man. This is the last captivity. That's good news, man. That's part of the gospel. That's great news. We're going to be ruling over our oppressors. That is great news.
O daughter of Zion, he will no more carry thee away into captivity.
Just explain that.
He will visit thine iniquity, O daughter of Edom. He will discover thy sins.
So you Edomites, and your sins are being discovered even to this day. Even as we speak, your sins are being discovered. All the wickedness that you've done is being discovered. You try to hide it through your secret societies. Okay? But it's all out there now, man. We already know you, Jacob Rothschild, David Rothschild, Evelyn Rothschild. Your ass is done, man.
That's right.
You can't die quick enough, man. As soon as you die, you're coming right back down here, bro. I don't give a fuck if you die 20 minutes before your house shot comes, bro. Guess what happened? You're gonna wake up in that same fucked up body, and you're gonna be digging that hole for them bodies, man. So we're gonna get on you, man. We're gonna pounce on your ass like white on rice, man.
That's
like,
right.
Like flies to shit, man. Like I said, hey, you asked the question, how the fuck are you gonna land, bro? How are we gonna come and do any work? Because that quick gonna be sideways in your ass, man. Soon as we get it. Even if you just die, we're gonna snatch you out the spirit world, bro. Put you on a body.
That's Ooh. Right.
Wow, you're gonna be in the spirit world. You know, see how it's shy and the most high you're and all your everybody chilling. Talking about, yeah, man, the only way to just do the right thing. You're gonna wake up in your body fucked up, bro. Stephen Hawkins, you're gonna be in that crippled ass body. And you're gonna have to dig a hole with your mouth, nigga. You better hope you're an Israelite. I hope you're not. But you're gonna have to dig a hole, man. All you gooks, you high-ranking gooks, hey, you better enjoy life, man. You better suck your teeth. Hey, if you haven't been on a man in a long time, you better get over there. If you haven't been on a horse, a equestrian ride in a long time, you better get on that horse, man. Because you're never gonna do it again, man. See, in the kingdom of heaven, it ain't gonna be no liquor. You're not gonna be able to get a heart. You know how Jake was able to get a stiff drink? You get your back whipped. Somebody that stole some of Master's rum from the house, from the big house, and they probably give it to Jethro, you know what I'm saying, because he got his back beat. Hey, here, drink some of this. And they ain't gonna be in the kingdom of heaven, man. They ain't gonna be in the kingdom of heaven, you got it, bro. Yeah, you're not gonna get no strong drink. Ain't gonna be no opioids. Okay, you're not gonna be having opioids. You're not gonna be able to have Zannies, Percs, none of that shit, yo. So that means your hardcore justice that's coming, you're gonna have to swallow that shit.
Raw.
But you like anything raw, like your brother said, raw. You got to swallow that shit raw. Yeah. That's what's coming. That's what's coming to you, man. Right. Okay? And we're announcing the judgment through your How About Chanel and Shot. Right now.
That was it on that, bro?
Yeah.
All right, so let's go back to the beat to 25.
We're going to start at 1. Because not only is Esau going to get it, all the rest of you Heathen Nation's going to get it too, man. You got it coming to you too, man.
Yeah.
You thought you was off the hook? Oh, we got it. We good. He ain't gonna destroy us. Why would he do that? He likes us. He just keep talking about Esau and the Edomites. We ain't had nothing to do with that. We were just here.
Okay.
Start off.
This is the book of Ezekiel, chapter 25, verse 1. The word of Yahweh came unto me, saying, Son of man, set thy face against the Ammonites.
Who are the Ammonites today? Hey, brother, I got a question. Who are the Ammonites?
Japanese.
That's right, Japanese. Guess what? You got judgment coming to you. All you got them Jets, you got judgment coming to you.
That's right.
Huh? Right along with Esau. Keep reading, brother.
And prophesy against them.
We're going to prophesy against your ass, man. The only difference that you ain't going to get is that you're not going to be eradicated after slavery, man. But you're going to get a hell of an ass. We're gonna make those chink eyes get big as fuck in the kingdom of heaven. Even if they swollen. And in my kingdom, bro, Ammonites and Moabites, Cyclops. They're gonna have one fucking eye, man. One eye, man. Right in the middle of their forehead, yo. How is this even possible? Deformity, yo. And you see it all the time, man. Judge. And it's gonna be all glaucoma out. Yeah, they're gonna have a cataract on there and shit. And you're gonna be forced to see, man. Keep reading.
And say unto the Ammonites, hear the word of Yahweh.
So here, all you so-called Japanese men, hear the words of Yahweh by Shin Yahweh Shai, man. We got a lot of goops over here in Hawaii, man. Keep reading, brother.
Thus saith Yahweh, because thou sayest.
Because y'all said.
Because they said,
Because thou sayest,
Look at these goops. Look at these niggas. Look at these niggas. Look at these, you know, big ass buck teeth, them chick ass eyes, people.
Against my sanctuary.
Yeah, you spoke against the Lord's sanctuary, man. When we were touching all hell, when we were going out of power, and y'all was asking me, man.
When it was profaned, and against the land of Israel, when it was desolate, and against the house of Judah, when they went into captivity.
Hey, what's up with all you nations, man? Why you nations always flexing on Judah, man? You always flexing on Judah like it's sweet. Oh, Judah's a bunch of bitch ass niggas. So let's talk about stuff, man. As a gook, first of all, you have permanent Down syndrome. When somebody's Down syndrome in the world, they always come out looking like a gook. Like a Japanese or a Chinese, man. You got permanent Down syndrome, and you think you're cool, man. These fucking gooks, man. They ain't about to destroy, man. Keep reading, bro.
Behold, therefore, I will deliver thee to the men of the East.
Yeah, the men of the East, the Israelites, man.
For a possession.
So you're gonna be our slaves, man. Huh? You think you cool because you can talk that goop shit? And the Most High played a terrible joke on you, man. Not only did he give you and your seed permanent Down syndrome, but you got that fucked up ass Hebrew, man. You sound like you banging pop together and shit. We gonna beat the shit out of you goops, man. Hey, I know I am, bro. I'm gonna get my... Hey, how the brother beats you out? YG Politics, I'm gonna take my shirt off for you niggas, man. Take my shirt off. Go ahead, bro.
And they shall set their places in thee and make their dwellings in thee.
Yeah, so that land, because you know their land is close to our land. It's right next to us, man. We were surrounded by enemies on all sides, man. So you other nations, man, you're not guiltless in this either, man. You too, man. You other nations, you're not guiltless, man. You're gonna take too, man.
Wait. They shall eat thy fruit, and they shall drink thy milk.
Okay, so everything that you have, all your substance, we're gonna take that. All of them, I know a lot of brothers, they like the goop women, man. Them goop women, man. You bust their ass open, it's like, yeah, man. Hey, a goop bitch, when you hear her, she'll make you feel like a king, man. Imagine when we get that ride back, man. Oh my God. And all we do is split gooks in half around here, bro. You know what I'm saying? Go ahead, brother.
And I will make Rabah a stable for camels.
Yeah, we're gonna park our camels and cars and chariots in your area, man. It's gonna be a parking lot, man.
And the Ammonites, a couching place for flocks.
Yeah, the Ammonites, your home is gonna be a couching place. That home outside of Israel, because Japan, the island of Japan, wasn't your original home. Your original home was inside, right outside of Israel, man, east of Israel. Okay.
You shall know that I am God.
You shall know that the Most High is who He is, man. Because you're going to be judged, man. Keep it, bro.
For thus saith Yahweh, because thou hast clapped thine hands.
Yeah, you clapped your hands. Man, you celebrated when we were. Again, I always say, when the room was taken out of the Assyria, what's happening, man? It's we probably think David's grandma was a Moabitess, man. Okay, I think King Solomon, his mother was an Ammonite, man. So you know he was popping your women, so you was hating on us and shit. Okay, whenever you read about the stories of us coming up against, y'all coming up against us, y'all ain't had no pity on us. Y'all wanted us to cut our right eye out. Even if you did that, you still want to make peace with us. And that's why I want to make you motherfucking Cyclops, man. All your right eyes gonna be gone, man.
And stop with their feet.
Yeah, so you clap their hands and you stop with the feet like, oh yes, you celebrate it. You celebrate it. Here it is, Japanese people, they venerate penises. They worship phallus symbols, man. Straight up phallus. If you go to Duke Land over there in Japan, they got dicks. They put them on their shoulders, put them on their heads, lollipops and shit. But y'all magnify yourself against the Lord's people, man.
And rejoice in heart with all they despise against the land of Israel.
So you clapped your hands, you rejoiced, you stomped your feet, and you rejoiced, you were excited. You was happy that we were taken down. Keep reading, brother.
Behold, therefore, I will stretch out my hand upon thee.
So the Most High is going to stretch out his hand upon you in judgment, man. Keep reading, brother.
And I will deliver thee for a spoil to the heathen.
Yeah, so you're going to be delivered to a spoil to the heathen, man. To the heathen too. To the rest of the nations, man. They gonna fuck you up, man. Go ahead, bro.
And I will cut thee off from the people, and I will cause thee to perish out of the countries.
That's what he gonna do, cause y'all spread all everywhere. Y'all look down here in South America, claiming to be a South American. Hey, they got the Peruvian president with a jet, man. A lot of you groups, you got high-ranking positions in South America, man. All in Africa, man. Trying to recolonize, you trying to colonize that shit? Yeah? You all over the world. So we gotta get your ass out of here, man. Keep reading, bro.
I will destroy thee, and thou shalt know that I am Yahweh.
So Yahweh about to be on God, gonna destroy you, man. You're gonna know that he's the power. Keep reading, bro.
Thus saith the Lord Yahweh, because that Moab.
You Chinese, you so-called Chinese, that's your name, your biblical name is Moab, okay? You're not Chinese, you're Moabites. Keep reading, bro.
And Seir do say, behold, the house of Judah is like unto all the heathen.
Yeah, that's what you did. And that's what they do in the ghetto. But these niggas ain't nothing but heathens, they're Africans. They're Hamites. We can do whatever we want with them. You feed us rats, cats, dogs, all that bullshit in the ghetto, man. Food that y'all don't need to eat. Y'all feed it to our people, man. And y'all talk to it through a thick 2-inch piece of glass. Okay?
Therefore, behold, I will open the side of Moab, yep, from the cities,
yep,
from his cities which are on his frontiers, the glory of the country Beth Yeshimoth, Baal Meon.
Hey,
God save Yahweh. This is chapter Ezekiel, chapter 25, verse 8.
Yep.
God save Yahweh, because that Moab and Seir do say, behold, the house of Judah is like unto all the heathen.
Yeah, so just like Esau and Moab, they type to Esau, man. You got, you like this. You so-called Chinese and you Edomites, y'all close, man. And y'all look at us like we're the rest of the heathen, man. Okay?
Therefore, behold, I will open the side of Moab.
So the side of Moab, since you want to be like the so-called white man, you want to be like Edom, you're going to get opened up, man. Go ahead.
From the cities, from his cities, which are on his frontiers.
Yeah, good. They got a lot of frontier space, man. Beijing. That shit's on the frontier, man. Okay? And you want to be just like the so-called white man, you know? You dress like the so-called white man. You talk like him. You walk like him. You act like him. So your city's going to be burnt up too, man. You Moabites, you Chinese, man. Especially you Cheeks, man. Because y'all all inside the ghetto as Koreans, Chinese. You go to every ghetto you go to.
The
chick store,
Chinese
store, and
nice store, nail
spas, the hair store. Oh man, we gonna when our women get a hold of you Chinese bitches, y'all be talking shit. When y'all be doing their nails, and they gonna put y'all bitches to death, man. They gonna throw you bitches over the table if y'all fuck up their nails, man.
Hi.
Huh? You fuck up that food, you fuck up that wash pot, you gonna get fucked up, man. Hey, you Chinese people, you gonna suffer, man. Go ahead.
The glory of the country Beth Yashemoth, Baal-Meon, and Kiriathaim unto the men of the east.
Yeah, so y'all gonna come to the Israelites too. Y'all gonna go to slavery unto the Israelites too.
With the Ammonites.
Yeah, because like Apostle Elder Aramoth said, man, hey man, with a kingdom, man, you got slaves, man. Somebody gotta do the work. And it ain't gonna be us. We
That's
did
right.
all the work. We built up every last major kingdom on the earth, man. The Israelites, man. So y'all gonna build up our kingdom, man. Go ahead, brother.
And we'll give them in possession that the Ammonites may not be remembered so among the nations.
So nobody's gonna remember you goofs, man. They're halfway thinking about y'all now. You fucking goofs, you chinks, you goofs. We gonna fuck y'all up, man. We gonna put a foothold in y'all goof mouth, man. We gonna make the teeth buck. And we're gonna take the finest of your women, man. We're gonna make them hate you, man. Your women gonna be the worst, man. Yo, the women that we take out of your nation, they gonna be the worst. They're gonna hate you. They're gonna hate their own skin, like Bernie Mac. I hate my skin because it's black. I hate my dubs because they black. I hate the black before it's put it to the neck. And I'm good for me the worst, man. Go ahead.
And I will execute judgment upon Moab.
Yeah, so judgment is coming in you, man.
And they shall know that I am Yahweh.
Yeah, you gonna know that Yahweh is who he is. Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai is the true power, man.
Ezekiel chapter 25 verse 15. Thus say Yahweh power, because the Philistines
are the Hamites. Y'all still on the earth. Well, I don't know which ones y'all are, but y'all still here. We're gonna fuck y'all up too, man. Y'all always been our enemies. Y'all were our first enemies. Tall, lanky, dusky Baptists. Come on, fuck you Hamites up, man. You sold us into slavery. Especially Judah. Go ahead, bro.
I've dealt by revenge, and I've taken vengeance with a despiteful heart.
Yeah, you took vengeance on them with a despiteful heart, man. Because we took your land. Because of the Canaanites and the Philistines, they were both our enemies in that area of Israel, man. That's why God of the River and God of the Philistines, the West Bank, the God of the Philistines, used to be the Philistines area. And the thorn in our side because we didn't get rid of the air. So the Lord kept us thorn on our side. So it was always thorn when we were back and forth, man. Fucking hand mics, man.
The Philistines were the ones Samson.
Yeah. Samson was putting death to you motherfuckers, to Yahweh Bashem Yahweh Shai, man. Yeah, the brother Kayah Mao said he's gonna have a whole lot of Japhetic Taskmasters out of one rock star. That's right, you are, brother. And many more, man. Like I was telling somebody, I was like, yo, man, our thinking level is low, man. Yeah, you're gonna be surprised if you have. Go ahead, bro.
And I've taken vengeance with this spiteful heart to destroy it for the old hatred. Therefore, thus saith Yahweh power, behold, I will stretch out mine hand upon the Philistines.
Yeah, so you Philistines, man, you're gonna be stretched out, man. You still follow your house by yourself, man. You're gonna stretch out that hand, man. You're gonna smack the shit out of you, man. You're gonna destroy you nations, man. Because you nations are our enemies. So you can drop that. Go to Psalms 83:1.
Book of Psalms, chapter 83, verse 1. Keep now thou
Bunya Loya. Nah, bro, we ain't gonna feed him on flies, man. We're gonna feed him a righteous diet, but it's gonna be slop. Flies not a righteous diet. And they already eat that shit now. So, nah. They want to have to follow the laws and commandments of Yahweh Hashem, even in their servitude.
The book of Psalms, chapter 83, verse 1.
Huh.
Keep not thou silent, O Yahweh, hold not thy peace.
So this King David was speaking to the Most High, man. And back then, he had all these nations in subjugation. So you know he was a prophet, so he was speaking about what's going to happen to his sons and his brothers down the line, man. Go ahead.
Hold not thy peace, and be not still, O Yahweh, for lo, thine enemies make a tumult.
So everybody outside of Israel is an enemy to the Most High. All you heathen nations, you are enemies to Yahweh Hashem and Yahweh Shai. Good. And y'all make it tumult. Good.
And they that hate thee have lifted up their head.
Yeah. All you nations, you hate us, and Allah don't exist. See the front. All you nations, you lift up their head because you hate us, man. You really, you hate Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai because he didn't choose your punk ass, man.
That's right.
Go ahead, bro.
They have taken crafty counsel against thy people.
Go ahead.
And consulted against thy hidden ones.
They took crafty counsel against the Lord's people, which are the Israelites, and consulted against the hidden ones, which are the Israelites, because we were hidden. We didn't know who he was, so we were hidden amongst the nations, man. Go ahead. And they took crafty counsel about what? Whether you're NATO, the UN, the world government.
They have said, come and let us cut them off from being a nation.
Yeah, you said cut us off from being a nation. So they kept us separated. You know, they came up with these different names. Whatever Israelites were at amongst them, they would say this, y'all this, y'all that. Let's cut them off, man. Cut them off all Israel from being together.
That the name of Israel may not be Selakia. That the name of Israel may be no more in remembrance.
Yeah, and not Israel, because they know Israel, but Yasha'Allah as a nation. You black, Spanish, Native Americans, yeah, it's not in remembrance, man. Try to erase world history. Okay? Go ahead.
For they have consulted together.
Y'all all consulted together, man. Go ahead.
With one consent.
With one consent, that's what confederate means.
They are confederate.
You are confederate, meaning together, man.
Against thee.
Against Yahweh Hashem Yahweh Shai and his people. Go ahead.
The tabernacle of Edom.
The tabernacles of Edom. You so-called white people. Go ahead.
And the Ishmaelites.
The Ishmaelites, you Arabs. Go ahead.
Of Moab.
You Moabites, you Chinese. Go ahead. You Chinese and Koreans. Go ahead.
Of the Hagarines.
You Hagarines. Go ahead.
Gabal.
Gabal, uh-huh.
And Ammon.
You Ammonites, you Japanese.
And Amalek.
And Amalek, you so-called Jews. We're gonna fuck y'all up, man. Okay? Y'all not strong. Look at that faggot. Fucking goof, man. Pump in the fucking ear, man. You a fucking faggot, man. Go ahead.
The Philistines, yeah. With the inhabitants of Tyre.
And you know there's some goofs there. It's like we're not even talking to them. Look at them dancing the odd shit. Look at these fucking chinks, man. Some audacity. Go ahead, read it again. Yeah, we're gonna fuck y'all up, man. Then we're gonna take your women. Go ahead.
Six, the tabernacle.
Oh, yeah.
The tabernacle of Edom,
yeah.
And the Ishmaelites.
Yeah, all you heathen nations, man. We're gonna fuck y'all up, man.
Of Moab.
Of Moab, you so-called Chinese and Koreans. Go ahead.
And Hagarines.
The Amites, go ahead.
Gabal and Ammon.
I think the Hagarines were Midianites, but I gotta look it up. Go ahead.
Who?
Gibor and Ammon.
Ammon, Japanese.
And yeah. Amalek.
Amalek, we're gonna fuck y'all up, man. You goofs, you chinks, jets, we're gonna fuck y'all up. Get ready. Especially you, proud, man. Go ahead.
The Philistines with the inhabitants of Tyre.
Yeah.
Asar also is joined with them.
All you motherfuckers are together, man. We're gonna fuck y'all up, man.
They have opened the children of Lot.
And the children of Lot are who, brother? Who the children of Lot?
The Moabites and the Ammonites.
And the Ammonites, man. Y'all, all you even nations, y'all help these nations, man. We're gonna fuck y'all up, man.
Do unto them as unto the Midianites.
Yeah, we're gonna do unto y'all as most I need the Midianites, man.
As to Caesarea, as to Jabin, at the brook of Kishon.
Yeah, that's it. So more judgment.
The spirit I had on the Yeah, we're gonna have all the heathens for our inheritance. That's what the Lord promises. So get ready, man, like your brother said. There's not gonna be no rest for you. Perpetual employment for all of you. 6 days a week, man. And you're not gonna have no rest if we're gonna be on top of you 24/7. And you better do everything correctly, because like one of the brothers mentioned, if y'all do something wrong, the last stone, you're gonna knock that shit over and you're gonna start it again from the beginning. Y'all like to be so perfect and neat and shit over here on this side?
Yeah.
We're gonna be the same, but even worse.
Worse.
So y'all gonna have to do everything perfect.
Right.
Come down upon Idumea,
Edom again, Idumea is the Greek version of saying Edom. Go ahead.
And upon the people of my curse and judgment.
Edomites are cursed with judgment. This is about to come. See, that's yeah, go ahead.
The sword of the Lord will be filled with blood.
Hey, that's what's coming, man. The sword of Yahweh Shinnah was shot. The nuclear missile is going to be filled with blood. The blood of who? All you need is, man. And 2 birds of Israel, too. Go ahead.
It is made fat with fatness,
yep,
and with the blood of lambs,
yep,
and goats.
Yep.
And the fat of the kidneys,
yep,
of rams, for Yahweh had they sacrificed in Basra.
Yeah, so the Most High gonna sacrifice you nations, man. Y'all want me to sacrifice the blood? Go ahead, brother.
And a great slaughter in the land of Idumea.
Yeah, a great slaughter in the land of Idumea, the modern day land of Idumea, is America, man. It's America. Spiritually, it's Solomon, Egypt, and the land of Idumea is America, man. Hey, this place is gonna be destroyed by nuclear power, bro. Hey, you know you're an Israelite, brother? You know your nationality? You know, you don't care, though. Lord willing, we'll be out here next week. Hey, to the brother, hey, all praise and honor and glory to Yahweh, by Jim, Yahweh Shai, double honor to the apostles and the elders at Great Millstone, the teaching word, the teaching sharing it, for doing well. Salutations to our fellow Aki. Keep pushing, keep striving. We're almost out of here. Shalom. Shalom. Survival call.